Good morning students, I hope you all are well. So as we have started our chapter 9, that is adaptation in animal, and in this chapter we have discussed that adaptation is very necessary for all the animals to remain alive, to remain in their surrounding, to remain in their natural habitat. After that we have discussed that all the animals adjust themselves to live into their environment for their food also, and to protect themselves from their enemies, they follow adaptation process, so they adjust themselves. Then we have discussed that adaptation to the environment. According to that, the habitat of the animals are classified into 5 types: terrestrial animal, aquatic animal, amphibian animals, arboreal animals, and the aerial animals. Then we have discussed terrestrial animals are the animals that live on land. After that, the terrestrial habitat or the terrestrial animals are again classified into 3 types: the animal that lives on the polar regions, the animal that lives on the mountains, and the animal that lives in the desert. After that, we have discussed about the specific points, the specific process that are known as hibernation and the estivation. Whereas hibernation is the long winter sleep and is followed by the animals to face the conditions of the scarcity of the food. And estivation is the long summer sleep and it is followed by the animals to escape the heat. Then there are aquatic animals, the animal that lives in water, and they have special features that help them to and that enable them to live in the water. Like they have gills to breathe in water, they have fins to swim in water. Similarly, the crabs also have the gills to breathe in water. If we talk about the turtle, they have the paddle-like flippers that also help them to swim in water. Then amphibians are the animal that lives on land as well as in water, and they have the features like this: whenever they are on land, they breathe with the help of their lungs, and whenever they are in water, they breathe with the help of their moist skin. Similarly, they also have barbed feet that help them to push the water while swimming. And they also, if you talk about the frog, they have strong hind limbs that help them to hop on the ground. After that, there are animals which are known as aerial animals. And aerial animals are the animals that fly. Mostly all the birds fall under this category, and they have certain features like they have hollow bones that make their body weight light, they have wings to fly, they have feathers all over their body. And if we talk about these animals like dragonfly and the butterfly, they have papery wing that help them to fly. After that, there are arboreal animals, and arboreal animals are the animals that spend majority of their time on the trees. For that, they have strong claws and strong limbs that help them to climb on the branches. And examples of these arboreal animals are tree lizard, monkey, polar bear, and squirrel. Next, today we'll discuss about the adaptation for food. How the animal adjusts themselves for the food, how they adapt themselves for the food. So for this, the animals are categorized into 5 main categories. According to the availability of the food, the animals are categorized into 5 main categories. Student, if we think that all the animals will eat same type of food, will it possible that there will be availability of food for all the animals? Will it possible? No, it will not be possible. Because if the all animals will eat same type of food, there will be scarcity of the food. That's why there is segregation of food for the different animals. There is different feeding habits followed by different animals. So we will discuss about them one by one. First of all, herbivores. Herbivores animals are known as plant eating animals. So the animals that eat only the plant and their part are known as herbivores. Examples are cow, goat, buffalo. Cow, goat, buffalo are the examples of herbivore animals, and they have strong front teeth to tear the leaves, and they also have strong grinding teeth to chew the plant parts. Next is about the carnivores. Carnivores animals are the animals that eat the flesh of the other animals. So they eat only flesh. Flesh eating animals are known as carnivores, and they have strong curved canine teeth that help them to tear the flesh. They have strong curved teeth, pointed curved canine teeth that help them to tear the flesh, and they also have strong grinding teeth that help them to chew the flesh and bones of the other animals. And they eat only the flesh of other animals. Examples are lion, tiger, etc. Lion, tiger, wolf, all are the examples of carnivores. Next is the omnivores. Omnivores animals are the animals that eat both plant and flesh. So, eat both plant and flesh of other animals are known as omnivores. So, example of these animals are crow, human being, etc. Crow, human being, etc. are the examples of omnivores, and they eat both plants as well as the flesh of other animals. The next category of the animal is the scavengers, and scavengers animal eat the flesh of dead animals. So, eat the flesh of dead animals. So these animals do not hunt the animals for their food. They eat the flesh of dead animals or the remains of dead animals. So examples of these animals are hyena, vulture, etc. Hyena, vulture are the examples of the scavengers. And last is the parasite. Parasites are the animals that live in or on the body of other animals and take food from these animals. So parasites are the animals that live either inside the body of the other living organism or on the body of the other living organism and take their nutrition from these animals. So the animal from that the parasite take their food are known as host. They live on or inside the body of other living organism and take nutrition from them. So either they live inside the body of other living organism or they live on the body of other living organism and take their food from them are known as parasites. So the parasites are again classified into two categories, endoparasite and the ectoparasite. Endo means those parasites that live inside the body of other living organism. So they are known as endoparasites. Like roundworm, hookworm and tapeworm are the endoparasites. They live inside the body of host organism. Whereas ectoparasites are the animals that live on the body of other living organism and take their nutrition or take their food from them. Like lice, ticks and fleas are the ectoparasites, and they have suckers or sucking tubes that help them to suck the blood from the body of the other living organism. So student, today we have discussed about the adaptation for food, how the animal adjust themselves for their food. On the basis of this, on the basis of their feeding habits, animals are categorized into 5 main categories. Herbivores that eat only the plant and their parts. Examples are cow, goat, buffalo. And these animals have a strong teeth that help them to tear the leaves, and also have the strong grinding teeth that help them to chew the plant and their parts. After that, there are carnivores. Carnivores animals are the animals that eat the flesh of other animals, and like lion, tiger, these are carnivore animals, and they have strong pointed canine teeth that help them to tear the flesh, and strong grinding teeth that help them to chew the flesh and bones of the other animals. The flesh eating birds like eagle also have sharp claws that help them to tear the flesh of other animals. Next is the omnivores. Animals are the animals that eat both plants and flesh. Examples are crow, human beings are the examples of omnivores. Next is the category of the scavengers. Scavengers are the animals that eat the flesh of dead animals. They do not hunt other animals for their food. They eat the flesh of dead animals like hyena, vulture, etc. Whereas parasites are the animals that live on or inside the body of other organism, of other living organism, and take their nutrition from these animals. And if we talk about these, parasites are of two types, endoparasites and ectoparasites. Endoparasites are the parasites that live inside the body of host animal, and ectoparasites are the parasites that live on the body of host animal. So student, this is all about your today's class. Thank you and have a nice day.